Dr. Deborah Haarsma is a frequent speaker on modern science and Christian faith at research universities, churches, and public venues like the National Press Club. She is president of Biologos, invites the church and the world to see the harmony between science and biblical faith. Previously, she served as professor and chair of the Department of Physics and Astronomy at Calvin College. Dr. Haarsma is an experienced astronomer with publications in the astrophysical journals on extragalactic astronomy and cosmology. She has studied large galaxies, galaxy clusters, the curvature of space, and the expansion of the universe using telescopes around the world and in orbit. She received her doctorate in astrophysics from MIT. Welcome, Deborah.
Hello, everyone. I am an astronomer, and in my research, I've studied galaxies, galaxy clusters, and the universe, the curvature of space. Behind me is a poster of one of my favorite galaxy clusters. And each of those yellow blobs that you see is not a star, but an entire galaxy of hundreds of billions of stars. The universe is incredibly vast. And most people, when they encounter this, have a sense of wonder and awe at how amazing the universe is, similar to when you walk outside and look up at the night sky. For me as a Christian, there's another layer to this, a layer of worship, because the Bible teaches the heavens declare the glory of God. The universe didn't just appear or arise from an impersonal force, but rather there is a person behind the universe. Scripture goes on when it is teaching of Jesus Christ to name him as the creator of all things. So the person that I know and follow as my Lord and Savior is also the creator of this amazing galaxy cluster. And that always fills me with just amazement and worship. For me, doing science does not mean setting aside my faith. I remember as a graduate student wondering if I should be neutral when I go to sit down and analyze data and somehow be objective and apart from my faith. But then I realized, no, it's the very faithfulness of God that allows me to do scientific research. God's faithful governance of all things across time and space gives that regularity that we study in physics and astronomy. Now, there was a time where I felt a tension and a conflict between my faith and my science. I grew up in a wonderful Christian family, but that did teach that the earth was young, and we thought Big Bang was a bad word in opposition to God. But when I looked into this more as an adult and I read biblical scholars, I learned more about what Scripture was actually teaching and how God in Genesis was speaking to an ancient culture that believed the earth was flat and they pictured the sky as a solid dome. And God didn't try to correct those misapprehensions and teach them what the world was really like. And instead, God taught them, however you picture the universe, I created each part of it, that God is sovereign over it all, and that he gave humans a special role in the universe. And that's what my takeaway is from Genesis 1 as well. And I would say that science there prompted me to investigate more deeply and come to a richer understanding of Scripture. And overall, considering God's word and God's world together, I feel I've come to a deeper faith in Jesus Christ.